And I think that the temptation for Saudi Arabia and its allies at the December meeting will be to just pursue the line of least resistance, persuade the non-OPEC producers to restrain production, to continue restrain production.
Take away Russia?
Yes. And obviously to pull some of the countries like Iraq and Nigeria, who have not been compliant, to toe the line. So I could tell you what we think they should do, but what they will do in December is totally a whole different question. It's really unclear right now on what they will do in terms of the OPEC meeting.
You're talking about putting pressure on some of the non-OPEC producers. I mean, where does the US stand in this? Because, of course, you know, OPEC has really no influence at all on what US producers are doing right now.
Yes. I mean, that's exactly it. Our expectations is that oil demand growth in 2020, based on the Argus Consulting team, is that we expect demand growth will be about 1.35 million barrels per day. Now, non-OPEC supply, we expect, is going to rise next year by 2.2 million barrels per day. So the only way that the call on OPEC crude can increase is if US production falls, and that looks really unlikely. You know, we do see that the growth next year for the Permian will be a little bit slower than this year, but it's not going to fall. So that is where that pressure comes from OPEC to manage the market.
So overall, nobody's in any mood to cut back production. At the same time, you've got this supply overhang still. So the outlook for prices?
Well, right now, if, let's say, OPEC maintains its current agreement beyond the March expiry, it's not going to be dire, because there will be some increase in demand because, as I said before, because of the IMO tighter sulfur supply cap, which we think that will lead to an increase in gas oil demand. So which is why our demand growth is higher. But it's not going to do anything to reduce the overhang in the OECD commercial stocks. And the concern is that in 2021, they're going to have struggled to balance the market because the demand is going to stagnate again. So we don't see that prices are going to fall sharply. In fact, in the next two quarters, we still think that prices are going to go up, but it's going to be tough. It's going to be it's going to be a challenge, I think, for OPEC.
Hi, I'm Emily Tan, and thanks for watching CNBC. You can check out more of our videos by clicking on the boxes on the screen, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more. Thanks for watching.